Very good evening. I am Dr. Indranil Bavadekar. I welcome you to my channel YouTube of Dr. Bavadekar's Homeopathy. So good evening everyone. Today by using this YouTube media, I would like to talk to you on a new subject, that is fear, or you can say like a fear with nervousness. Nowadays we see that due to the COVID pandemic, everyone is at home. People are working from home, students are studying from home, secondly they are attending schools, and because of all these things certain problems have arisen, like there is a recession, people are not sure about their jobs, people are not sure about their salaries which they are getting less, and because of all this stress and strain, if somebody is the only earning person in the family, then he has a tension to run the family, pay all these daily expenses, his overheads. Then he's running the family, like electricity bills, for example, telephone bills, internet bills, is any EMIs of house or any his shop. So the financial stress is for everyone. So I've seen that in many patients there is a fear of the future. Not only fear, this is fear with nervousness. What will happen? Nobody knows. People are taking care, the due care has been taken, still we see the negative things that many deaths are happening. Probably in future they will come in control. But here we are experiencing that patients are coming to us with physical complaints as well as the mind complaints. Now in these mind complaints, fear with nervousness or quite anxiety, in medical terminology, we call it as neurasthenia. N-E-U-R-A-S-T-H-E-N-I-A. I will be using this word many times, but the simple meaning is fear and nervousness, both things combined together. Now the term neurasthenia, it was used in 1829 to label mechanical weakness of the nerves, which was a major diagnosis in many patients. So this term is very old. In North America during the 19th century, George Millian Bird reintroduced this concept of neurasthenia, having two things together, in 1869. Now in neurasthenia, what are the symptoms that we see in neurasthenia? There are many, many symptoms we see, but commonly seen symptoms, there at least two symptoms should be seen to label a patient of neurasthenia. What are the symptoms? Patient feels dizzy, there is a digestive disturbance, there are aches and pains in the muscles and the backs or any other parts of the body. There are tension headaches by looking at the screen, overthinking, overstretching your mind and body. Then sometimes there is inability to relax. Even if you try to relax, you cannot relax. There is no sleep, loss of sleep, insomnia, and there are quite disturbances because of the thoughts recurrent coming one after the another. This is all due to the current situation people are facing these problems. If any of the two symptoms are present, we call this as neurasthenia. So the subject is very important, which I thought to talk with you, which is related to the brain and the nerves and disturbance of the mind leading to disturbance of the body. Now, what are the exact signs and symptoms which you see in patients? What do they come and tell us? Common things are really what they tell us. They tell us that they feel very sad and they feel run down sometimes, especially in the evening period. Then they have excessive fears, worries. Sometimes they feel guilty also, that because of them certain things are not happening in their house. Then there is extreme worries which make them, you know, like mood changes. Sometimes they are very irritable. Sometimes the people feel like crying. Sometimes they keep quarreling. Husbands and wives, they start quarreling with small things because they are more over available at home to each other. Secondly, because of these fears and the nervousness which they face. Also, some people complain of significant tiredness. In Hindi we call it thakan, and low energy even though after sleeping well. So these are the common symptoms which you call upon this. Then people who experience such things, what do? Slowly, these people, those who suffer from neurasthenia, they start withdrawing from the society. They don't attend common things, they don't attend meetings, they don't attend anyone on phone for a long time. So they try to be alone, closed room, sitting alone, listening to the mobile, listening to the computer or browsing. Just they try to isolate themselves. Sometimes because of no physical exercise, there is poor appetite, then loss of also appetite, then eating is less, even sleeping is poor because there is no exercise at home at present. So people are just lying down and there is no physical exertion, so they don't sleep also. Because of this nervousness, they become lazy and there's a poor body hygiene also to maintain. Then sometimes they feel that even though everything is well, they feel sudden mood changes, irritability. Then they feel again, they become quiet. There are many changes which we see in patients which were normal before. So because of this all home life or isolation life or confinement, we see this. Now, this is all due to the weakness of the nerves, which our the brain has been taxed or it has been worried. So like how to prevent this thing or what to do in these situations? See, medications is not only answer for this. The situation is going to change whenever the time comes, whenever some good medicine, vaccinations are available, or this COVID situation goes away by the worship of God. By his wish, when it goes away, everything will be smooth. But till then, what to do? So, I would like to suggest the patients the following things. They can do regular exercises at home. Exercise gives you good oxygenation. Circulation in the body is also established. At least half an hour exercise in their own room or indoor exercise will do. If they are smoking a lot by being at home and sitting on their work, they should reduce down or stop smoking. Smoking makes you tired and increases the nicotine level of your blood. They should take plenty of rest, physical rest as well as mental rest, away from the screen, away from the addiction. They should take plenty of rest. That is very important. They should eat a balanced diet. There are many videos available for balanced diet. So according to their own likes and dislikes, they should take a balanced diet. They should take plenty of fluids which will hydrate their body and make them comfortable. Also, for relaxing the mind, one of the good things is meditation. If you believe in meditation, it is a very vast subject, but one should meditate at least 1 hour a day, which will make you fresh and this neurasthenia symptoms will come down. Friends, in this nervous system, to make our brains, the nerves of this brain strong, there are certain things which are helpful also. So I'll tell you some top food great things which will make your nervous system strong. So in diet, you can have green leafy vegetables. They're rich in vitamin B complex, vitamin C, E, magnesium, and which are even these all vitamins are important in maintaining the nervous system of our body. Also fish they can use. Then dark chocolates are also very helpful to stimulate the nerve. Eggs, then salmon fish, avocados, almonds. Any of these you can use once a day, not all at a time. Now, there is a nerve damage or you can say nerve weakness which results in this neurasthenia or like say fear as well as tired feeling. For this, omega-3 fatty acids are found to be very helpful, which are effective to give strength to the nerves of the body. So, we get plenty of omega-3 fatty acids from salmon fish. But some people have fear that COVID or the infections may come from salmon. I don't know whether it is proved or not. But there is an alternative of vegetarian things also for it. You can get omega-3 fatty acids from walnuts. You can get from sardines. You can get it from canola oils. You can get it from chia seeds, flax seeds, mackerel and cod liver oil. Now, here in India, I mean Maharashtra, located in Pune, bananas are ample and it is a middle class food for us. So, are bananas helpful for this condition? Of course. Banana eating a day will really keep you healthy to build up your nerves. Bananas are the best of vitamin B, source of vitamin B. They help in calming down the nerves. Then they contain tryptophan, which is a protein, and body converts it into serotonin. Serotonin is a happy hormone that keeps our mind happy. And usually we feel very cheerful. So eating banana per day is very helpful. Be cautious in patients who are allergic to banana or who are diabetics. That is the only care. Now, in such a way, if you have a good diet, meditation, proper food, and you help your brain to become strong, definitely your all symptoms of fear, nervousness, and resulting in the body disturbance will come down. Now, in short, I will go through some few homeopathic medicines which are found to be effective in such cases. Now, aconite nephalus is one of the medicine where we see that people have fear with nervousness, especially fear of big sounds. They have fear of dark or when the lights are off, fear of train. They have delusions that some problem is going to come in future, so they are very much disturbed. For such patients, aconite will be very helpful. Another medicine is phosphoric acid. People feel exhausted and weak due to brain nerves getting involved. So fear, they feel sleepy all the time. There is no sleep, but they feel sleepy. Sometimes there is heavy legs in the legs, especially during studies, during work. They feel very heavy practically and they cannot work. So in such cases, like acid phos is helpful. Ignatia, this medicine is very long for a long lasting grief. People have fear of coming problems in future. Then they get fear by small or big sounds around them. It means from deaths of some relatives. Now we see many deaths because of this COVID. If some near one dies, they get severe depression, they get grief, nervousness. For such patients, ignatia is found to be very helpful. And picric acid is there. In picric acid, we see weakness of the brain, especially of businessmen. Here, there is aversion to work. Businessmen don't feel to work also. They feel hot or lazy. With little physical or effort they do, they feel very dull and get tired. Sometimes there is occipital headache. The headache hits at the backside. Then in the morning, they feel heaviness in the back and the legs. If such symptoms are found, then the medicine picric acid will be very helpful for such patients. Then Nux Vomica, it is one of the polycrest remedies and well-proved remedy, which is one of the effective remedy. At that you can think where patient gets angry easily. You talk something to him and he gets very angry. He get restless from small things and small thoughts. Bechain ho jata hai patient. There is sleeplessness with thoughts of depression, horrible dreams, and they are associated with digestive disturbances. In such patient, Nux Vomica is one of the golden remedy which we can think of. Another remedies for these are Anacardium orientale, Argentum nitricum, Pulsatilla, Selenium, Natrumur. The list is unending. So friends, few remedies I have just told you to know that they are very effective along with all the lifestyle modifications. So everybody kindly take care, come out of this fear and this nervousness or a neurasthenia and stay happy, stay healthy. But one simple advice, take homeopathic medicines with the advice of physician or homeopath which is around you. If you don't find, you can contact me on my WhatsApp. I will be happy to help you. If you like my channel, kindly subscribe it and stay healthy. Okay, everyone, goodbye.